your favor. Where would I be without your presence? In your presence, 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 in your presence. Shalom, and a warm welcome to this International Online Sunday service. Those who are partakers of this great grace, honored by God to be a part of this supreme anointing, blessed to be in this place. What a marvelous time we have this morning in the presence of the Lord as our Father takes us into the Word of God as we gather here for that one unified purpose. Pastor Kwaramba, joined by Pastor Chikuni, and in a few moments, we will be hailing the presence of the prophet. Shalom, man of God.
Always good to participate in a greater vision. Always good to be here, Pastor Kwaramba. It's an amazing time in the presence of the Lord.
Indeed, the effectiveness
of God's word.
Of God's word.
An amazing time. You know, Pastor Kwaramba, it is one thing to call yourself a man of God, and it is another to reflect the word of God from the inside. Our Father is coming here and giving us Jesus, who is the Word. And we are seeing the presence of God, not just in his life, the presence of Jesus, not just in his life, but in our lives via the process of teaching and ministering to us. And believe you me, there is a way that the word transforms an individual, not just by being present, but also by hearing.
Yes.
And we are hearing the word of God. And obviously, faith comes by hearing.
Mm-hmm.
We are better individuals every single moment that we hear our Father minister.
Mm. Mm. And we derive profit from what we hear when we do.
Ah, ah, ah. It's important. It's important always when you sit down and you listen. I believe that in as much as many may come to the fore and talk about the word, there comes a time when the word speaks to us. And what we are witnessing is the word speaking to us.
The word speaking to us about itself. there's nowhere else where this can be found, where the anatomy of the word is broken down for us to really understand its effectiveness. In the mouth of two or three witnesses, a word is established.
What we are witnessing, you rightly mentioned the effectiveness of the word. I believe that when you hear, when a word is spoken over your life, what is important is not just the word, but the manifestation of the word spoken. So it is one for one to speak a word over your life, and it is another for the manifestation of that which has been spoken over your life. And the good thing about the voice of our Father Prophet Emmanuel Makandi, over the years that we've been with him, we are growing younger. That's the word spoken to us. We are prospering in our ways. That's the word spoken to us. We are in good health. That's the word spoken to us. We are prospering in every aspect of our life. And that's the word spoken to us. And look at where we are now.
Yes.
That's the manifestation of the power of the word.
Mm.
Mm. And what else can we expect?
Mm. Radically changing us inwardly and outwardly.
Exactly.
The power of the word, the indwelling word.
Believe you me, there are terrains that had we not had the word, we would have never navigated.
Yes.
There is a life that we live today. Had we not had the word from the voice, a father, not by name, but by ordination, we would have never been able to get where we are to today.
Man of God, you mentioned a very powerful point that is a reiteration of what our father said last week concerning the word dwelling. By reason of our presence, in him, around him, because of our exposure to the word that he has perpetually given to us. You've mentioned changes that have taken place in our life. And we've dwelt, and we are seeing the manifestation of that word. We are seeing glory as a result of that word dwelling enough
within.
Exactly.
And, you know, one of the things that I've tried to study about our Father is the fact that you can never separate him from the word. So when he's ministering to us and advising us that if you dwell long enough in the word, you become the word. We are seeing that practically in his life.
Yes.
Give him any scripture. Talk about anything that is coming from the word. And you begin to hear the word in a way that you begin to think that indeed, or you begin to understand the fact that he lives within him. Jesus lives within him. The word resides in him. And whatever he then decides to speak, he's coming from an informed position.
Mm. An informed position. It was last week that 20 years after a certain incident happened, we got to know.
At one point, I wanted to come in.
Why the word is so effective.
Yeah. Everything that you will say.
The word was spoken by the word. And that word made the man the word.
I love the humility. I love the application of the event in the message.
Mm.
And if you are not smart, you will not know who it is that was being talked about. I won't say much about that.
Wow. So secret encounters, those precious moments that he's had with the Lord. And exactly. He's so generous to share them with us.
Yes.
And we're grateful that this opportunity has once again been created. And we trust that you are prepared to receive this very wonderful morning. Allow us to introduce the prophet. Greetings, our Father.
Greetings, I'm so much delighted to be here today.
Thank you, Father. Since last week, now we understand the secret.
Is that so? The word spoke a word.
And something happened on your lips. We wonder sometimes at the effectiveness of the word that you speak. And now we understand why.
Yeah.
Because the oneness is only not expressed in how you live your life, but in also what you say. And so we feel that effectiveness, and that effectiveness causes effects in our lives.
True.
We thank you so much, Father, for last week's service.
Father, we are here for you. We are here for your word. And we understand that the worlds were framed by your word, so that we can now see the things that were once invisible. You spoke them into being. And once again, you are just about to speak. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of what you're doing in this era. And we thank you again for giving us understanding, for opening our eyes and the ears of our hearts to understand. And we are again ready for you this wonderful morning. All right. We are still on the same subject, which is the effectiveness of the word of God. Jesus said that, like we said last time, the words that I speak are spirit and they are life.
Yes, Father.
And I would like to congratulate again our viewers that are here today, coming and knowing that God always has something to say. And thank you for being here. It is such a blessing to me knowing that you are coming for the people that are already waiting for you to come on board. The level of hunger is unexplainable. The yearning that people have for the word. To think that people in their thousands, they come here knowing we are not coming to get anything in terms of being handed over. Maybe a bottle of oil or maybe a bottle of water. They are coming just for the word. They are coming for the word. I like that. I like that.
Thank you, Father. It's you that has taught us that, Father.
Oh.
There was a time when we yearned for so much more. And you brought us back to the understanding that the word is more important.
It's everything.
It's everything.
It's everything. It's everything. It takes time to bring people to that level of understanding. Because for years you keep on arguing it. But thank God at least we are here.
Thank you, Father.
A place of understanding that it is the word that matters,
yes,
the word. Now, we are here now talking about its effectiveness. The effectiveness of God's word. Notice, Jesus didn't say, in as much as that is also the truth, he didn't say the words are spirit. He said, the words that I speak. If it is I speaking.
Wow.
It is the spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak.
There is an I. If it is I speaking
unto you,
then be rest assured that Those words are what?
They are spirit.
They are spirit, yeah.
And they are life.
They are life. Not only do they give life, they are life. It's not just the giving of life. The words are life. So when words are spoken, life has been spoken out. He speaks out life and not just words. Inasmuch as every word is a spirit, but he's trying to measure the intensity of the spirit that accompanies his word. The words that I've never seen such a leader. The confidence that God has in himself.
That's why I follow.
How? Come on. Knowing that when it is you speaking, it's a different story. It's a different story. He's not saying the rest of the people, when they speak, their words are not spirits, but he went on to also name the same word, life. Right there is telling us not everyone has that ability to speak life. But when it comes to the spirit of the word, every word spoken is a spirit, but not every word spoken is life. So, but if it is I, the Lord, speaking, take not. It is life spoken. Life spoken. Life is spoken. That's how life is created. It is spoken.
Wow.
A letter to Timothy by the Apostle Paul. 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse number 2. 2 Timothy, that was the second letter that Paul wrote to his son Timothy. Chapter 4 and verse number 2. Preach the word.
Preach what?
The word. Ha! As if there is something else to preach. Preach the word.
Preach the word.
Preach the word.
When?
Be instant.
Yes.
In season.
In season.
Out of season.
Okay. Let's stop there.
Wow. Before he got to that point, verse number 2, in the first verse, he tells Timothy that he is charging him right before God. I charge you before God and before the Lord Jesus Christ himself, who is able to judge both the quick and the dead at his appearing and the appearing of his kingdom. I charge thee before God to preach the word.
Wow.
I charge thee before the Lord, before God, that you preach the word. And you do it in season and also out of season. So he's letting him know that there comes a time when your word sounds irrelevant. There is a season that is coming where your word sounds like it has gone out of context. So he's encouraging him still to go on and preach despite the contradictions around his area. And he's saying, do not observe do not consider the season. You just go ahead and preach the word. There is a reason, because I would want to touch on that aspect today, so that we get to a place where we now begin to appreciate the effectiveness of the word of God, especially when it comes to the creation of seasons. The creation of seasons, because we can't just be talking of the effectiveness of the word of God and then not talk about what the word is able to bring about. Effective in doing what? Today it is in the creation of a season that you longed for.
Wow, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you.
It's going to be very brief, very short. You study in the book of John, chapter 5. John chapter 5 in verse number 4. Very common text. If you've ever been to church, you've probably heard that scripture being preached several times. Verse number 4.
For an angel went...
There is an angel of the Lord that
went down.
He went where?
Down.
So he's coming from an elevated position. You would assume he's coming from heaven. An angel, a messenger, would descend. What is he coming to do?
At a certain season.
At a certain what?
Season.
There we have it again. Season. He's coming at a certain season. There is a specific season where you would have this angel of God coming down.
Into the pool.
So he's coming from heaven into
the pool.
He's coming from heaven into the pool at a certain season.
And troubled the water. Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in, was made whole of whatsoever disease he had.
Whatsoever disease he had. The condition there was simply timing. No matter the severity of the disease, the condition, as long as you would be the first to jump in, it ceases to matter what sort of a disease you had. It would go. So it was a matter of not just faith, but timing. Timing. And right there was a man who was impotent.
That's right.
He had an infirmity for 38 years. And to think that within that period of time, when this man was under such an affliction, there has been several episodes, several occasions, and several seasons where this angel of God would still come down and stay and trouble the waters. We are not being told when this exercise started. But during this time, of 38 years, there's been opportunities for him to recover. But he was losing it when it comes to timing. And there was a man there.
Yes. And a certain man was there.
A certain man was there.
Which had...
Where was he?
There.
He was there. Where the thing was happening.
There.
You can be there. In the right church. In the right place. And things are not happening. You can be there. In the right organization. Right company. You can be there. And yet things are happening to everyone else around you except you.
You.
He was there. He's not missing it because he's absent. The man is there. You are there. You are there. You are there.
Preach it for him.
He was there. He's not at home. There was a time when this man was at home and he was told, there is a place called there. If only you can be there, you will recover from your sickness. Then the man went there. And he remained sick whilst there. Where things are happening and other people are testifying. Where you begin to ask yourself, are these testimonies real? Is it true that really God does these things? Why is it I only get to hear about what God can do from other people? I thought I came to the right place. He was there. He was there. Right there, there was a certain man, yes.
Which had an infirmity, 38 years.
That's a very long time.
When Jesus saw him lie.
When? Jesus saw him lie.
And knew.
Don't forget who Jesus is.
Yes.
He's the Word. And when the Word saw him lie, the Word knew. An intelligent Word. When the Word saw him, there are times when the Word sees you. And it comes to where you are. And the Word knows. I told you before, the Word knew. It's intelligent enough to know.
Yes.
To know. A servant who was sick at home, the Word spoken, knew where he was.
Yes.
The Word is so intelligent. It sees you. It locates you. It knows your condition. What is about to happen here, it's a transition, which is very, very outstanding to me. If I'm to look at what is happening there. To think that there is an angel of God who is coming, frequenting this place, and he troubles the water, and whoever gets in first recovers. Now, the most critical part is where the Bible says, in a certain season. The reason why the season was not named, it wasn't specific. It wasn't at a certain hour of the day. Had they known the exact hour, you would stay as close as possible to the water. But the angel would allow the people to relax. You would spend days without coming. Until you begin to lose your attentiveness. Then he comes abruptly and then he stirs the waters. So the season was not stipulated. It wasn't known. It remained mysterious. Why the season was very, very hard and even impossible to predict. It is because of the creation of that season. The angel of the Lord would not come in a certain season. No. It is the coming of the angel that would create the season. There wasn't any specific season where you would have the angel of God coming. It was given to him, the angel, by God to introduce the season. So you don't wait for the season and then expect the angel of God to arrive. It is the arrival of the angel that becomes the arrival of the healing season. That's strong, Father. Right at that point, I want you to take note of the importance of certain visitors. There are people that when God really wants to bring about a season in your life, that season is determined by the arrival of a particular individual. When that man arrives in your life, when that woman arrives, it is the arrival of a season. You don't just welcome a person who has come. You now embrace a season that accompanies the man. That's what the prophet said. Go and tell Ahab that I'm here. Why? Because God had told the prophet, I want to send the rain. So go and show yourself. Oh my God. Go show yourself. Because I'm ready to send what?
The rain.
Because the prophet had said, not until I speak, you won't see rain, nor even dew. So it is based on my appearance that you'll get the rain.
Yes, Father.
And what he spoke was heard, and it was recorded. And there was no dew for 3.5 years.
Yes.
Now, even when God was ready, everything was in place for it to rain. But then God remembered, there is a representation of a season. I can cause the clouds to appear, but it will never rain until the prophet appears. So go and show yourself, because you are a representation of a rain season. Unless you are seen, they can't see the water. Go show yourself. Go and introduce the season. Your appearance becomes the appearance of the water. So this angel is coming, not at a certain season. He's bringing a certain season.
Strong Father.
His coming becomes the coming of a season. Now, hear this. Hear this. Hear this, child of God. You have to hear this. You have to hear this. Once the waters are troubled, that becomes the season. If you are the first to take advantage of the season created by the angel, it would not become everyone else's season. It becomes your personal season, whilst everyone else remains sick. We are talking about preaching the word in season and out of season. Why is he talking about seasons? He's trying to help this young man understand that it is what you say that creates seasons. Don't go by the season, because the seasons go by the word. Even when you feel like you are out of a season, go ahead and speak.
That's strong, Father.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Wow.
Now, at first, it was time for the angel. The opportunity, the right was given to the angel of God. Descend from heaven, enter into the pool, and introduce a healing season. But then that moment expired at the arrival of the word.
Strong power.
So when the word appeared, Jesus, when he appeared at the pool, he's bringing another season now. Because at this moment, we don't have an angel that is coming from above into the water. The messenger who carries the message comes straight to the afflicted man. Right where you are. Where it's no longer you visiting a season. Now the season is visiting you where you are. And the word then asked a question, do you want to be made whole? Then he went on to explain the predicament which is taking place all along. The angel of God comes here and then he stirs the water and then the word is asking, do you want to be made whole?
Yes.
It took him time to realize that this was the introduction of another season. Where, if the word is spoken, when the word begins to speak, you immediately have a season. It was as if Jesus was preaching the word out of season. He's talking about healing. But the healing was sort of like out of season because we don't have the angel coming to
Right.
The water.
Right.
Because Jesus understands that what you speak, you are actually creating the season. You no longer have to wait for the men to come. You speak the word and the season comes. Do you want to be made whole? That's the word asking the man. And the man says, I wish I could be the first one to jump into the water. But before I get in, someone else gets in first. And I have to wait for another season. Do you want to be made whole? Do you want to be made whole? Do you want, the word is asking, do you want to be? It doesn't matter, it's 38 years. Do you still want to be made whole? For such a very long time in that affliction, do you still have the willingness to recover? Do you want your situation to change? Do you want to be made whole? You have to look at what the word then said to the man who was sick.
Verse 8, Jesus saith unto him,
the word said unto him,
rise, take up thy bed and walk.
Rise. These are orders, instructions. The man is being charged by the word to rise and take his bed and walk. And it took him 2 weeks.
Immediately.
And immediately,
the man was made whole.
He was made. There is a making. He was made whole.
Wow.
He was made by the word. The word has power to make you jump up and walk. He was made. He was made by the word to rise up. Where it is the word making.
Wow.
Ha. You rise according to the spoken word. He was made to rise. You will rise. You will ascend.
We receive.
The promotion will be according to the spoken word.
We receive it.
Oh my God. He rose according. You tell your neighbors it was according to the word.
Yes,
Father. And I rose. You will ascend according to the word.
We receive.
Elevation is according to some. Now, because some people don't understand. Sometimes it's according to the academics. You got a degree. But in this case, it was according to the word. He was made by the word to rise. Made by the word to rise.
To rise.
You excel according to the word.
You see, Father.
He's able not just to walk. He's carrying a luggage. There is weight on him, on top of him. The once afflicted man, impotent. The man who was weak, he could not even jump into the water. He failed to be the first. He always wanted to be the first in his generation. He failed. The only time he became the first was when the word arrived. The last became the first. He became the first in that dispensation of the spoken word. He became the first. All the manual and physical methods, you failed. You failed. But here comes the season of the word. You become the first to experience the effectiveness of the spoken word.
We receive
of God.
We receive.
Ha!
Oh my.
Why? Before, he had to wait for the man to arrive and bring a season. But now, the season has come because the word has arrived. Now, Paul is telling Timothy,
yes, Father,
preach the word in season and out of season. So he's saying, act as though you're not seeing what is happening. Preach even the opposite of what you're seeing. You see, when a word is spoken in season, the book of Proverbs says that when a word spoken in season, how good is it? It's a good word when it is spoken. It's right season.
15 verse 23.
There's nothing wrong with that, yes.
A man hath joy,
yes, and joy
by the answer of his mouth.
His mouth, yes.
And the word spoken in due season.
In due season, when a word is spoken in due season.
How good is it?
It's a good word, but it's not the best.
It's a good word.
It's a good word.
It's a good word.
But a word spoken even out of season is greater than a word spoken in the season. It's a good word. You see, the difference, some people might not understand. What is a good word in the right season? When you are sick and you are in pain, at that moment, you want to have someone who gives you hope. My brother, this season that you are in will soon come to an end. We are going to be rejoicing very soon. Because you are going to recover. Those are very nice and so comforting words. You would love to hear that because you are in a season of pain. And such a word, when it is spoken, how good is such a word? Because it is compatible with the season. And we seem to enjoy those good words because they are coming in season. There is a greater word that comes in that same season, which doesn't talk about healing. A greater word in that kind of a season is, you are not sick. That's a word out of season. At a time when you are weak and you are told you are strong. At a time when you are poor and you are told you are rich. That's a word out of season. Because the devil is so cunning. He allows you to keep certain good words until the season arrives. Then he doesn't allow such a season to ever arrive. And now we are receiving a certain approach to situations today.
Yes, Father.
Don't consider the condition that you are in. Speak in season when it is good for you to speak. Speak even when you're out of the season. Why? Because now it is what you say that determines the arrival of the season. You speak seasons into existence.
Oh my, oh my.
You see, doctors are not allowed to utter those statements because their methods of helping the sick are physical. They have to agree with you that yes, you are sick. But supernatural people, it is given to them to preach the word out of season. To preach the word out of season. Like in the season that we are in right now, nothing good has to be said. But we have to. Because it is what we are saying now that brings about the season that we desire. You have to preach the word even out of season. Because it is the word that brings the season.
Thank you, Father.
Let the weak say, I'm strong. You might be in a condition right now. And you have been there for 38 years. Might not be 38 years, but you've been in that condition for a very long period of time. And you are waiting for things to change so that you can speak the word. And yet things are waiting for the word to be spoken. So that the situation can change. I remember visiting my friend's house. He had his brother who was taking care of him. He was still young. I was also young. Go to his house and we are in one of the little huts and we are praying. We'll do that once in a week or so. I knew his bigger brother was sick. He had a very strange condition. Doctors had tried everything, but nothing seemed to be working for this man. Yet my friend is being looked after by his brother, who is sick, who is also looking after. So you wonder who is looking after who. We are there. I'm praying. We are praying together. So now I think things were really getting worse. And he realized that maybe I'm about to die. But the last chance that I have, let me use it wisely. And then he came in leaning on two sticks. He's not even able to walk. For 7 months, this man was lying on the bed. He can't even work for his family. Sick. He's lost weight. The man is dying. He came in. For the first time, he asked for a prayer. And I'm wondering, I'm always here once every week to pray with my friend. And he never came, he never asked for this. He never asked for this. Why is it for the first time this man is coming? Looking at him, I had not seen him for quite a while. You couldn't even look at him. You said, this man is gone. This man is gone. What am I seeing there? It's a season of death. The man's time is up. The little strength left, he used it to come in, crawling, asking for prayer. Did I pray for him? I didn't pray for him. I asked him to go back and rest. He said, go back and rest. He said, just pray for me. I said, once you are gone, you are our next prayer point. Go and rest. As he was crawling out, he turned back, he looked at his brother. He said, remember, the millimeter is almost finished. You need to take the corn to the grinding mill tomorrow. You use my bicycle. As he was crawling out, then I spoke a word. I told him, he is not going to do that. It is you tomorrow. You will have to go to the grinding mill. Otherwise, you're not going to eat. He kept looking at me and he said, what a mockery. Why insult me like that? And I never responded to that. Then he went his way into the next room. Now, at the shopping center, the Growth Point, my father had a supermarket there, and I'm the one working in there. The following day in the afternoon, I heard a sound right outside of the veranda. And the bicycle fell. I thought somebody had fallen. And the man walks in, sweating.
Wow.
He stood right at the entrance. I was busy saving some customers. Even myself, I couldn't believe what I was seeing. What a sight. He began to weep. Having cycled for 4 kilometers, and is about to cycle again 4 kilometers going back home. He is milling me on his bicycle. The following day, no prayer was made for him, but a word was spoken. The assignment he had given to his younger brother was transferred back to him. I said, you are the one going there tomorrow. And right there, we are witnessing a fulfillment of a spoken season. No matter you are in what condition, once a word is spoken, for 7 months, the man could not walk. And the following day, that's immediately according to me. That's immediately. Science cannot even confirm such a thing. When God gave us the word, what he gave us was the material. When God gave us the power to speak, he gave us the power to create season.
Yes.
You have to speak. That's the effectiveness of God's word. What is the word? Somebody might be wondering, is there any specific word that I need to say? The moment you mention Jesus, I told you last Sunday, the name Jesus is a gathering. The name Jesus is a compilation of all the names of God. The name Jesus is a term given to the most successful experiment, where you have the conversions of names and the power that comes out of that meeting place is called Jesus. Jesus, it's called Jesus.
Wow.
It's called, when you mention the name Jesus, why is it that sometimes you call upon his name and then nothing happens? And you think the name is not that effective. You don't just use the name of Jesus by speaking it out. When you leave the name Jesus and then you speak it out, you leave the name Jesus. You live, you make the name your lifestyle. Then when you speak the name Jesus, it is the life that you speak out. Explain it, Father.
You know, when you follow Jesus, when you're following Jesus, right? When you're following Jesus. When you're following Jesus, even if you choose not to follow the Bible, it's the Bible that you're following. By following a person. And also, if you choose to not follow Jesus and you follow the Bible, it is Jesus that you're following. Because he is the manifestation of his word.
Yes, Father. Yes, Father.
There are people like that, that when you follow them, you will never violate the Bible. Because they are not a violation of scriptures.
Yes.
I hope somebody's following.
Yes, Father.
And those people in your life, they represent a season of the word. No matter what the circumstances are, no matter what the situation looks like, it matters what is being said. Your season is starting right now.
Yes, Father, we receive
it. We receive it, Father.
Your season and your moment, it is starting right now.
We receive.
Not because it was here, but because the word is now here.
Yes.
When the word is spoken, once the word is spoken, you will rise according to the word.
We receive. Yes. We receive it. We receive it. Oh, we receive.
Child of God, you have been lying there for years. No movement whatsoever, emotionally, spiritually, financially. You have since stopped going forward a long time ago, but movement has come.
Yes.
Why you no longer have to wait for a certain magnificent appearance of an angel from heaven, the arrival of the spoken word.
Yes.
Once Jesus is here, stop waiting for the angel to descend. Stop waiting for the angel to descend. The word has arrived. Jesus is here and he's speaking a word. Rise up and walk.
Yes.
You are moving forward. You don't have it in your pocket, but you have it in your ears right now. You are hearing the word and your season is right here.
Yes.
I'm saying this. You might be waiting for me to pray it out, but I'm here to speak it out.
Yes.
I'm here to speak it out.
Yes.
The same Jesus who said, the words that I speak are spirit in their life, is speaking to you right now. And what is being spoken towards you is a spirit of excellence. And life is coming to you right now. No matter what they said, whatever they spoke, those were inferior spirits. Here comes the superior spirit. When Jesus speaks, the name above every other name, the name above every other name, I've told you in the spiritual laboratory, they sat down, they said, what comes out if we are to compile all the names of God? In one word came out, Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus. And the reason why you have to live the Jesus life first before you speak the name
It is because such a name becomes so dangerous, because it's as good as you have one key that unlocks every door. You can't leave that key everywhere, carelessly. That name is the most powerful weapon. And to avoid unqualified people using that kind of a name in wrong ways, it has to be lived first.
Wow.
It has to be lived. The name has to be lived first. You live the name and then you go on. You are given the right to use the name. When you speak Jesus, when you speak Jesus, when you speak Jesus, out of a life of Jesus. You get to that moment where you become a contradiction and you become a confusion to some people around you, because you are not saying what is supposed to be said. You are not saying what is supposed to be said. Everything is against what you're saying. You are starting a new season in your life where you don't only live what you preach, but you preach what you live. You have lived it by your preaching. Even when you preach it, you go on to live it. There's no more any demarcation between you and the Word. If you were spoken into being, speak everything else into being. You open your mouth and speak a season. Don't wait for the season to arrive. It will never arrive. The arrival of the Word is the arrival of the season. Your time has come.
Receive.
In Jesus' name. Thank you, pastors.
Wow. What more can I say? They are men, they are people whom when you follow them, you don't violate the Word. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. You're welcome. Thank you, Father, for the exceptional Word. Thank you so much, Father. The effectiveness of the Word of